Students, let us see the timing diagrams for the minimum mode in the read timing cycle and the write timing cycle. So in the previous video I explained about what is the minimum mode system. Now let us see the read cycle for minimum mode of a 8086 microprocessor. So this is a clock pulse we are giving. So each this is one pulse and this is another pulse. So like this, total four pulse will be there. So complete four pulse, we call it as one cycle. So in this one cycle, one operation will be performed. Means the fetch, decode and execute. This fetching the data, decoding the data and executing the operation, everything will be done in one clock pulse. So one timing cycle. So one timing cycle is having four clock pulse. So each cycle is having four clock pulse including waiting time. So during T1 clock pulse, address latch enable becomes high. So whenever this is high during T1 cycle, so then we can send the address and data onto the buses. Next, address and stator bus. So this is during T1 clock pulse, the bus high enable will be active. After that, so I said during four clocks, during one pulse, address will be active. So after that, the status during the remaining pulse, the status will be active. So whenever I am discussing about the diagram, the pin diagram, I explained that. So address and stator bus. So first the bus high enable and the address A19 to A16. Thus it takes the first pulse. After the remaining pulse will be given to the status bus. Next, address or data. So during the first clock pulse, A0 to A15 will be generated. Means the first the address will be placed on the address bus. Address is placed on the address bus. After that, the data will be placed on data bus. So because this is multiplexed, so first we have to be demultiplexed the address and data. So that is AD0 to AD15 will be demultiplexed as A0 to A15 and D0 to D15. So first address will be placed to where we have to send the data. That address has to be placed. After that, the bus is reserved for data in, that is D0 to D15 during remaining clock pulse. So in the first clock pulse, the address bus will be placed. In the remaining clock pulse up to T4, the data will be placed. So this is a read cycle. So that's why we have to be RD bar is active. RD bar means 0 bar. 0. So this is 0. 0 bar. 0 bar means active. That is the 1. So during which pulse? T2 to T4. So T2 to T4, the data bus is active. So we are performing read operation. So we are reading the data during this clock pulse. 0 bar means 1. So that's why this is comes like this. This is a down. In the same way, DN bar. DN bar means 0 bar. 0 means down. So 0 bar means 0 bar. It is active in this pulse. Data enable. So here we are doing the read clock cycle. So read clock cycle means reading data means we have to receive the data. Reading, receive. Data transmitting means writing. So reading means we have to make this 0 bar. If you want to make this R bar as active 1, you have to put 0. 0 bar. 0 means down. So this will be active. So I hope you understand. So whenever this is 1 DT by R bar, so this is read becomes 0. 0 means it's a down cycle. 0 bar means 1. So this will be active in read will be active. So this is about the read timing cycle. Now let us see the write cycle for the minimum mode. So this is everything is the same, but only the difference is instead of reading, you are just putting the writing. So WR bar. So WR bar means 0 bar. 0 means down. So from during T2 to T4, this will be active. So it is writing the data. So we have to put whatever the data we have read from the read cycle, that valid data should be placed on the data bus from T2 to T4, valid data placed on the data bus. And during D1 clock pulse, so address will be placed on address bus. So A0 to A15 will be placed on the first clock pulse, and the remaining clock pulse from T2 to T4, the valid data will be placed on the data bus. So whatever the valid data that is placed on the data bus, that we have to be write to the external devices. So that's why this will be active. Then you have to make the data enable will be active. So 0 bar becomes 1. So that's why it comes to downwards. And here this is a data transmitter or receiver. We have to write the data. So we have to do data transmitter. So 1. So 1 by 1 bar means 0. So data transmitter is high. So from during T1 to T4, data transmission will be done. So this is about the write cycle for minimum mode. Thank you.